In the next few meetings, I will present our results regarding formation on one-dimensional oriented structure in chitosan-based hydrogels. Hydrogels are polymeric networks obtained from synthetic or natural polymers stabilized through physical or chemical crosslinking. Also, hydrogels are able of changing volume and or shape in response to external stimuli, including temperature, ion strength, pH, electric and magnetic field. Therefore, hydrogels have numerous applications in many fields, such as wastewater remediation, controlled delivery of drugs and proteins, tissue engineering, cell profilation, stabilization of sandy soils. However, hydrogels have some drawbacks, such as low equilibrium swelling, low mechanical stretching. To overcome this inconvenience, the solution is obtaining composite materials based on naturally components with improved properties. In this context, the objective of our work were preparation and characterization of some novel cobalt imprinting composite materials based on chitosan and zeolite as cryobits, investigation of the sorption capacity of cobalt imprinting composite, the removal of template cobalt ions from multi-component aqueous mixture where cadmium, copper, iron and nickel ions were the competing species. Evaluation of the sorption mechanism, taking into consideration the sorption isotherm models. The sorption of cobalt ion and reusability of the composite cryobits. Why natural zeolite and chitosan? A strong interest addressed to biosorbent as a cost-effective alternative to activated carbon and synthetic ion exchangers. Natural zeolite presents a series of advantages, high resistance to elevated temperatures, on excellent compatibility with the environment. However, the cation exchange capacity of zeolite is relatively low, but could be improved by their incorporation into composite sorbent. Chitosan are presented chelating properties for heavy metal ions. The schematic representation for the synthesis of cobalt imprinting cryobits is presented in this scheme. Our synthesis strategy consists in combination of ion imprinting on unidirectional freezing methodology. Ion imprinting on non-ion imprinting composite SBs were prepared by dropping the polymer zeolite crosslinker mixtures in liquid nitrogen, followed by their transfer into a cryostat at minus 8 Celsius degree to complete the crosslinking reactions. In the last step, the removal of template cobalt ions was successfully achieved by EBITDA as shown by the change in color of this from pink after the composite synthesis to light yellow after the cobalt leaching. In this table is present sample code, swelling ratio of ion imprinting on and non-imprinting composite cryobit. As can be observed from the table, the swelling ratio values of cobalt imprinting composite are higher than those of non-imprinting one, regardless the pH values and zeolite pretreatment strategy signs a large fraction of chitosan amine groups participate into the chelating process. The imprinted composite are less cross-linked by glutaraldehyde, signs more amine moieties were involved into the complexation of template ion and thus after cobalt leaching, granting the easier access of water of the binding chelating sites of cryobits. The FTIR spectroscopy was used to demonstrate the chemical composition of cryobits. The main characteristic pairs of chitosan and zeolite were found in the FTIR spectrum of sorbent. Incorporate of cobalt ions into the material structure did not significantly affect the chemical structure of composite. The internal morphology of ion-imprinted cryobit was examined by ECM. As can be observed, the cross-section morphology is almost similar for all cryobits consisting of a radial lamellar pattern, typical for material prepared using this freezing procedure. The compressive stress strain curve of composite cryobits were performed on swollen stack. The old zeolite reinforced cryogel have high compressive strength that the chitosan cryogel with zeolite. The sorption property of ion-imprinted cryobits for removal of copper ion were investigated by BAT technique. The sorption capacities and the selective parameters were calculated using equation presented in this slide. To describe the equilibrium sorption of cobalt ion onto the composite cryobit and the affinity of this heavy metal ions for every type of sorbent, several theoretical isotherm models were used. In these figures is present the isotherm for sorption of cobalt ion onto ion imprinting and non-ion imprinting cryobits synthesis with zeolite activated with the chloride acid. Also, isotherm for sorption of cobalt ion onto ion imprinted non imprinted cryobits, synthesized with zeolites, activated with sodium chloride, is presented in these figures. The best performance in cobalt sorption from single component aqueous solution was achieved when the zeolites imbibed into cryobits were activated with sodium chloride. The values of isotherm parameters for cobalt sorption on sorbent corresponding of the SIPS double Langmuir and Fredling model PH4 are listed in this table. The best fitting isotherm model describing the heavy metal ion sorption was dependent on the cryobit's composition, but the high correlation coefficient and the low square Q square test and root mean square error values indicate SIPS and double Langmuir isotherm as the best fitting model for describing the cobalt sorption on the ion imprinting cryobit, regardless the treatment strategy on imbibed zeolites. The Freundlich equation was successfully applied for analysis of cobalt sorption onto non-imprinting composite when zeolites were both in acidic form and sodium form, and proved to be the best fitting model as confirmed by the parameters of fitting goodness. The sorption properties under competitive condition were evaluated at two pH values for N6. In this regard, copper, nickel, iron, and cadmium ions were selected here as competitive heavy metal ion for cobalt ions. As can be observed from these figures, when the pH of sorption was changed from 4 and 6, the selectivity of ion imprinting cryobit towards cobalt ions or considerably decreased. Moreover, it is also apparent that the iron ions are preferentially retained in this condition. We have studied the reusability of the cryobits in consecutive desorption cycles. The ECM image of the cobalt loaded cryobits indicate the lamellar pattern even after heavy metal ion sorption, which support the high stability of these sorbent materials. The cryobits exhibited a remarkable chemical stability during the loading leaching stage. Of cobalt ion, the sorption capacity remaining almost constant after the 5 CF cycle. In conclusion, novel ion imprinting chitosan-based composite cryobits, we contemplated selectivity for cobalt ions were successfully developed by combining the pH-dependent absorptive feature of activated zeolite with ion imprinting technology. The maximum sorption capacity values for cobalt sorption for single component aqueous solution, non-competitive experiments were achieved when the zeolites incorporated into the ion-imprinted cryobit were conditioned with sodium chloride. The presence of zeolite with cryogen matrix generating mechanical stable composite up to complete compression with instant recovery of original shape upon water addition. Successive sorption-desorption cycles show remarkable chemical stability of composite cryobits during experiments. Acknowledge the support, the financial support the project. Thank you for attention.